No, thank you. Thank you very much, comrades. I am Comrade Tisetso Magama from BDS. It's indeed an honor, comrades, to welcome all of you, Comrade DSG, Comrade Second DGS, and and the leadership collective. Yeah, no, these days, comrades, we deal with acronyms, you know. you know, you have all these acronyms. I heard the other day, Parliament is POSA, Parliament of the Republic of South Africa. And so we go on. Comrades, it's indeed an honor for me to stand here on behalf of BDS, firstly to welcome all of you, but also to say a few words, paying tribute to this colossus, who has indeed made such a contribution, not only to the deliberation of our own country, but we know the contribution that the Cuban people made to the liberation of the people in Asia, in Latin America, and indeed in Africa. Indeed, as you've seen in the clip, Comrade Fidel really made a profound point, which is that Cuba's outlook, Cuba's global perspective, has nothing to do with the material resources that it can extract from any other country or partner. But it has to do with the basic elementary internationalist duty that a revolution such as Cuba feels or has towards the entire oppressed peoples of the world. Comrade Soli was talking about it. I saw him on television making this very important point to say that when Cuba eventually withdrew from the war in Angola, which is, of course, the most, I think what is stuck in most of our minds is the decisive battle of Quito Guanavale, where South African troops were defeated decisively, and indeed which represented a turning point in the battle in Angola. When Cubans went back to Cuba, all they took were the body bags of their dead comrades. If I'm not mistaken, I think the number was something like 6,066. Comrade Soli, some of you might remember. I think it was 6,066 dead cadres who have lost their lives in service of humanity. And so, comrades, when we celebrate our own liberation in South Africa, lest we forget that it was the international community that has made a significant contribution to the fall of apartheid. We have the propensity these days to look at international crises in the context of a narrow definition, the typical American definition of what constitutes their national interest. I can tell you, comrades, that's a fundamental mistake. Our own struggle, and indeed our victory over apartheid, was born as a result of the solidarity of the international community, and in particular, sacrifices made by people like Comrade Castro, and indeed the Cuban people as a whole. And if we forget that, we will certainly forget what defines this liberation. Many comrades have made this point, comrades, that the history of South Africa, of this democratic South Africa, cannot be written without Cuba. And indeed, that is the case. And so as a country, it is absolutely vital that we continue on that trajectory, that we show solidarity and indeed support the struggles of other peoples that are still oppressed and colonized today. In that context, we refer to, amongst others, the people of Palestine, who are today still subjected to the most brutal occupation, the demolition of houses, the imprisonment of children, the expulsion of people from their land of birth, the most heinous crimes perpetrated against the defenseless people. Crimes, comrades, I can tell you that would embarrass the most ambitious psychopaths. And so it is absolutely crucial that as a country, we are always counted amongst those who stand up and say, but not in our presence. Not in our presence. That is exactly how we benefited from the solidarity of the international community. There are the people of Western Sahara, themselves today still remain colonized. Recently, we've seen the passing on of Comrade Mohamed Abdelaziz President of Polisario and President of the Sahrawi Arab Republic. A comrade who has, like Comrade Fidel, who has indeed sacrificed his entire life for the liberation of his people. South Africa, the African National Congress in particular as the governing party, but on all sectors of our population, including the leagues, COSATU, civil society, must renew their commitment, comrades, because the death of a comrade like Fidel seriously challenges us to rethink our positions, and especially, Comrade Jesse, to rethink our reluctance in taking part in these kinds of campaigns. Because Comrade Fidel understood very well what Comrade Jose Marti said, who was affectionately known as the Apostle of Cuban Independence, del Apostol de la Cubano Independencia, who said that every true human must feel on his cheek the blow struck against the cheek of another. That is the essence of solidarity, comrades. And it is that kind of solidarity that the people of Cuba have displayed and continue to display towards all the oppressed peoples of the world, and indeed especially those in Africa and Latin America. And so as we will be laying Comrade Castro to rest, let that serve as a new inspiration for us to recommit ourselves to his very principles of social justice, to his principles of freedom, the right to self-determination, and that we cannot rest until that strategic task has been achieved. On behalf of BDS, the BDS board, thank you very much, and all of you are welcome.